Hello everyone. In this lecture, I am going to deliver you the architecture, algorithm, and the control parameters of back propagation neural network, which is widely used for solving many nonlinear problems in the science and literature. Back propagation. What is back propagation? So it is a kind of learning algorithm used in a multi-layered neural network architecture whose weight updation is based on gradient descent approach. And the architecture of this particular neural network will be like this. It has set of input layers, it has set of nodes in the inner layer, there is a set of nodes in the output layer, and the connections are from each input layer node to each other node in the hidden layer. Say for example, from node x1, the connection goes to z1, the connection goes to zj, and the connection goes to zp. Likewise, for each node in the hidden layer, the connection is to goes to each node in the output layer. From z1, the connection is to zy1, yk and ym. Like this, from the connection from zj, the connection goes to y1, yk and ym. And if you look at the architecture deeply, you can find lot of notations over the connections, and these notations represent the weights. In this particular architecture, the weights between the input layer and the hidden layer are represented using the letter V. Likewise, the weights between the hidden layer and the output layer are represented by the weights W. Accordingly, the numberings are given for each weight parameter. If a connection is from first node of the input layer to the first node of the hidden layer, then the suffix number for the weight will be like this, that is V11. If the nth connection of the nth node connected to the jth node of the hidden layer, then the connection weight have a suffix number VNJ. Likewise, you should give the number for all the connections. Similarly, the same terminology is followed for the weight between the hidden layer as well as the output layer. The output produced by each output node will be small y1, small yk and small yn. And what is this TO, TK, TM is target. And this y1, ym, yk are called the output produced by the network, and the TO, TK, TM are called the output that is taken from the data, that is actual output. So that's all about the basic architecture. It is a three-layer architecture. This is called a bias. So this is the bias in the connection between input layer and the hidden layer, and this is the bias in the connection between the hidden layer and the output layer. These bias also have connection to every other node in the hidden layer. So that's it about the architecture. And this particular architecture is driven by an algorithm called a backpropagation algorithm. The understanding process of this backpropagation algorithm have three phases. Phase 1 is a feedforward phase in which the input signals are going in the forward direction. And the second phase is backpropagation of error. The output produced by the model is compared with the target, and the error is calculated, and that error value is back propagated to find the change in weight and bias, as well as to proceed to the next iterative process. So the third phase is weight and bias updation. Here how the weights and bias are updated in the output unit as well as in the hidden unit, both are discussed. First, let me come to the phase 1, feed forward phase in the hidden unit. Net input. How net input calculated? The net input is calculated using the expression here. Z in j is equal to V o j plus summation I equal to 1 to n xi vij. Then we go to the previous slide to explain this. That is z in j, that is the net input that get collected over this node zj are from x1, xi and xn, which has the weight v1j, vij and vnj. So in addition to that, it has a bias voj. So the net input over this particular node is voj plus summation i equal to 1 to n xi v 1 j. So that is the expression. Likewise for output unit, to produce the output you have to apply activation function over the net input. So the same thing for output unit, the net input calculation and the output. And the calculation of error is nothing but TK minus YK, that is target minus actual output, and it is delta Y. So now change in weight is calculated. Change in weight is nothing but learning rate, error calculation value and the corresponding node value. So likewise the input values are calculated, the error values are updated accordingly. So new weight is equal to old weight plus change in weight. The change in weight is calculated in the phase 2. Del Vij, del Wok, del Jk. So these are all new weight calculation. And the new weight, the change in weight calculator is utilized in the third phase to find the new weight. And this process is going on both in the forward as well as in the backward direction to find the final. If you look at the process involved, it is a gradient descent approach. That is, the weight values are initialized randomly with some value, and that value, the error is some particular value. Say for example, in this way case, the error is around 50 for the initial weight value of 0, W0 and 1 is something between 1 and 2. And over the iterative process, it is observed that the error is minimum. See, now the error comes close to the 0, and that particular point W0 is something between 0 and minus 1, and W1 is something between 0 and 1. So this particular process is called as gradient descent approach, which focuses on updating the weight values towards the minimization of error. These are the control parameters that you have to consider before developing a backpropagation neural network model for any problem. Number of training data. So in general, neural network learns a particular concept with the help of the data. So once you have collected the data has to be divided into two parts. One is for training the data, training the network, another one is for testing the data. So it may be divided in the ratio like this, or you can go for some cross-validation strategies. Nature of training. There are two modes of training. One is pattern mode, another one is batch mode. In pattern mode, errors are calculated for every data, whereas in batch mode, errors are calculated for a group of data. Selection of networks. This is the most important part in applying neural network model for any problem. That is, you should decide on the number of input nodes, you should decide on the number of output nodes, number of hidden layers, number of neurons in the hidden layers and the activation function. For every points, the clarity is given in the bullet points. That means for number of neurons in the hidden layer, that is I want to decide how many number of neurons I need to have in the hidden layers. So it depends on the problem. So there are trial and error approach. Normally when you are going to simulate the ANN model for any problem, you start with one layer. And if you go on increasing the layer one by one, and if you find any good result, you keep on going. Otherwise, you can stop the number of layers, or you can limit the number of layers to one, and you can design the number of neurons to either 3 or 4. Depends on the problem performance of your cases. Weights and bias. So this is the major role in developing the ANN neural network model. That is, the objective of developing an ANN neural network model for any problem is to find out the suitable value for weights and bias. Of course, we know the input from the data, and we know the output from the data. our objective is to find a linear relationship between the input and output with the help of the weights value and bias value. So normally we don't know the weights and bias value, so we follow the gradient as an approach which always aims to find the suitable weight value for suitable value for the weights and bias towards the minimum of error value between the target and the output. Learning rate and the momentum, these are the two parameters, that is alpha and eta, are the two parameters that controls the step of learning process in the ANN model. So normally it takes the range, that is learning rate takes the range from 0.001 to 10, and the momentum rate is from 0 to 1. See, these two parameters helps in the faster convergence of the neural network model. Termination criteria. Okay. Repeatedly I have to do feeding of input, calculation of the weight, updation of the weights based on the error value between the input and the target, and again the weight values are utilized to modify the connections, and the process is going to and fro. So how long I have to carry out this process? So that is set by termination criteria. You have two parameters to define the termination criteria. One is epoch, another one is goal. Either you can set the epoch to a maximum number, so this much time of iteration I have to do it to find out the output, or you can go for the goal. Goal is nothing but minimum acceptable error between the target and the output. And one critical issue in developing a neural network model that for any kind of problem is generalization. That is, you should know how well that your neural net model make prediction for the data that are not in the training set. So you need to always try to achieve a balance between memorization and generalization. That is, too much of training leads to overfitting or memorization. So the training needs to be taken care of, or training should always be associated with some kind of validation. Or the simple strategy that you need to follow is, whenever the error begins to increase, the net is starting to memorize the training patterns. At this point, the training is terminated. Thank you.